Good morning. Today we are going to discuss the next topic in chapter 5, arithmetic progression, nth term of an arithmetic progression. Let a1, a2, a3 go keep on moving, be the ap, that is arithmetic progression. In this, the first term will be my a1 and the difference between the first two terms will be the d. First term is a1 and the common difference is d. Now see here, the first term a1, let us write this as a. The second term is a2. a2 is nothing but a1 plus d. Now this a1 plus d, a1 value is a, so we can write this as a plus d. Now this can be also write as, see here, a plus d, this I will write it as a plus 2 minus 1 into d. This d I will write it as 2 minus 1. This is the second term, so second term minus 1 divided by d, sorry, into d. Third term a3, that is equal to a2 plus d. a2 is nothing but a plus d, so a plus d is a2 plus of d. Now this is equal to a plus 2d. Now this can be written as a plus 3 minus 1 into d. Next, a4 is equal to a3 plus d. a3 is nothing but a plus 2d, so a plus 2d plus d, that is equal to a plus 3d. This can be written as a plus 4 minus 1 into d. See here, if it is 4, here 4 minus 1. If it is 3, say 3 minus 1. If it is 2, 2 minus 1. So if it is n, then it is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. If n term is the last term, then this is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d will be the last term. Therefore, the nth term of an ap, that is an, equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. An is also the general term of this ap. The general term of the ap is a plus n minus 1 into d. And suppose if they are giving the first term a and d, they are giving, they are asking us to find the 17th term, 18th term, that n is equal to 17, so n is equal to 18 we have to take, and directly we can find the 17th term and 18th term easily there. Now if there are m terms, if there are m terms in the AP, then AM represent the last term. How many terms are there, they are saying, then that much term, that is the last term. M terms are there means then the mth term will be the last term. 17 terms are there means 17th term will be the last term. N terms are there means nth term will be the last term. Which term they are saying is that last term, that term, that will be the last term here. Here m terms are there means then the mth term will be the last term. So this can be written as the last term L is equal to a plus m minus 1 into d. So this is the last term. The general term an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d, and the last term L is equal to a plus m minus 1 into d if m is the m terms are there. And your last term will be a equal to a plus m minus 1 into d. Now based on this concept of the nth term as well as the last term, let us solve few problems in this exercise 5.2. The first question given here is, given that a equal to 7, d is equal to 3, n is equal to 8, find the value of an. Now just now we have learned the formula, general term, that an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. The a value given here is 7 plus n value given is 8 minus 1 into d value is 3. This is a8. So this is equal to 7 plus 8 minus 1 is 7 into 3. So 7 plus 7, 3 is 21. So this is equal to 7 plus 21, that is 28. So a8 is equal to 28. Now the next question given is, a is equal to minus 18.9, d is equal to 2.5, n value we have to find here, an value they have given here. Now let us apply in the same formula, that is an is equal to n minus 1 into a plus n minus 1 into d.
Now in this I know a n that value is 3.6. This is equal to a value minus 18.9 plus n value we don't know. So n minus 1 let it be there as such into d value here given is 2.5. Now this is equal to, now we want to find the n value. So let us take the terms into the next side. So 3.6 minus 18.9 when goes to next side it will become plus 18.9. This is equal to n minus 1 into 2.5. Now add up these two, so this will be equal to 22.5. that is equal to n minus 1 into 2.5. now 22.5, n minus 1 will be as such here, keep it here this side. This is equal to 22.5 divided by 2.5. so now get cancelled here, so this is equal to 9. This is equal to n minus 1. Now n minus 1 is equal to 9, then n is equal to 9, minus 1 goes next side, it will become plus 1, that is equal to 10. Therefore n is equal to 10. The value of n for the given a, d and a n is equal to 10. The next question, in the following AP, find the missing term. See, they have said that this is an AP. So AP means it is understood that the common difference between the terms are equal there. So from that AP, that is understood. So difference between the number is same. Now we have to find the missing term. So in between these two, in between these, I don't have these two terms. These two terms we have to find out. Now this is an AP means this can be taken as the first term. This is second term, this is third term, and this is my fourth term. Now the first term is my a1. So let a1 is equal to 5. a2 term I don't know, a3 term I don't know, a4 term I know, that is a4 is equal to 9 1 by 2. Now first term is there. Second term, how to write the second term? A2 is equal to A1 plus of D. And A3 is equal to A2 plus D. So if I know the D value, with this if I add the D, then I will get the A2 term. Then A2 is there, with that I again if I add D, then I will get the A3 term. So now my aim is to get the D value there. So with these two values only we have to find the D. Now A2 we have written as A1 plus D, A3 we have written as A2 plus D. Now next term A4 is there. A4 is equal to, we can write this as A plus, we can write this as A3 plus D, or we can write this as A plus 3D also. This A4, AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So A4 means 4 minus 1, that is 3D. Now this is equal to 9 1 by 2. Now in this I know my A value, that is 5. So 5 plus 3D is equal to 9 1 by 2. We can take it as a improper fraction. It is given in the mixed fraction here. So 9 into 2 18, 18 plus 1 is 19, so this is equal to 19 by 2. Now take this 5 to next side to find the D value here. So 3D is equal to 19 by 2 minus 5. So cross multiply, 10, 19 minus 10 will be 9 by 2. This is equal to 3D. So D is equal to 9 by 2 into 1 by 3. So these two cancel. D value is equal to 3 by 2. Now we know the D value here. With this D value, we can find the A2 value as well as A3 value also. Now A2 is equal to A1 plus of D. A1 is 5 plus D value is 3 by 2. So add up this. 5 into 2, 10, 10 plus 3 is 13 by 2. This is A2 value. Similarly, A3 is equal to a2 plus d, that is equal to 13 by 2 plus d value is 3 by 2, that is equal to 2, 16 by 2, that is equal to 8. So a3 is equal to 8, a2 is equal to 13 by 2. Hence we have found the missing values of a2 and a3. Next, find the missing term. See, before that, first term was there, last term was there. So with that we have found. Now the first term also is not there. I know some terms are given in between here, and the next term given here is minus 22. Now we have to find the missing terms here. They have said this is an AP. So AP means it is understood that the common difference is same here. So let us write the general term, that is this one is A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 and A6. These are the terms. Now A1 value we don't know. Given as A2, that is A2 is equal to 38. This A2 we will be writing as A1 plus of D. Next, A3 value I don't know, A4 I don't know, A5 I don't know, A6 is there. That A6 is equal to minus 22. This we can write it as A1 plus 5 D. Now these two things are there. With this, let us try to find the value of the D here. So if we found the D value, then these terms we can find easily. Now let us take this term as my first equation, and let us term this term as the second equation. Now in these two terms, let us apply the method of elimination here, and let us find the value of D. Now see that second equation minus first equation, that is A1 plus 5D is equal to minus 22, and A1 plus D is equal to 38. Now let us subtract this, so sign change will be there. See, here I have same sign, that's why I am multiplying throughout this with a minus sign. Suppose here I have plus sign and here I have minus sign, means all the things I have to multiply with the plus only. So there will not be any sign change there when we are doing with the plus. If it is of minus, everything will get changed in the sign there. So now after the sign change, now these two will get cancelled. This is plus, this is minus, these two will get cancelled. 5D minus 1D will become 4D. This is equal to minus 22 minus 38, that is equal to minus 60. So D is equal to minus 60 by 4. Therefore D is equal to minus 15. Now D value we have found there. Now from this we can find our A value there. So A1 is equal to A2 minus D value. If I do, then I will get the A1 value. Why? Because A2 is equal to A1 plus of D. Take this to next side so that we will get this one. So A1 is equal to A2 value minus D. A2 is 38 minus of minus 15. Now this is equal to 53. So A1 value is 53. Now let us find A3 value. So A3 is equal to, this value is 38. Now A3 equal to A1 plus 2D. A1 is 53 plus 2 into D value is minus 15. So this is equal to 53 minus 30, that is equal to 23. So A3 value we have found. Now A4 value, so A3 plus D, that is A3 value is 23 plus of minus 15, that is equal to 8. Now A5 is equal to A4. A5 is nothing but A4 minus of, so
a4 plus d. So a4 is 8 plus minus 15, that is equal to minus 7. Now a6, that is equal to a5 plus d. a5 is minus 7 plus of minus 15, that is equal to minus 22. Hence that what value we have found for d is correct. We got the a6, that is given value is correct. A6 is minus 22. Here also we got A6 is equal to minus 22. And A2 value is 38 given. Here we got correctly. See, the next question given here is, which term of AP? See, the AP is keep on going in this way. In this, I need the value of 78. I don't know what is that N value so that I should get 78 there. We have to find for which term I will get the answer as 78 here. Now let us assume that I want to get the value 78 and that is my last value. So if that is my last value, means then this will be equal to my AN. So AN is equal to 78. Now from this given AP 3, 8, 13, 18, A value is equal to 3 and D value is equal to 8 minus 3, that is A2 minus A1, this is equal to 5. Now A value I know, D value I know, AN is there. Now we want to find the N value. So AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. AN value is 78, A value is 3 plus N minus 1 into D value is 5. Now take this to next side. 78 minus 3, this is equal to N minus 1 into 5. 78 minus 3 is 75. Now take this to next side, divided by 5, equal to N minus 1. Now this is equal to 15. That is equal to N minus 1. Therefore, N is equal to 15 plus 1. That is equal to 16. So, for the 16th term of this AP, we will get the value 78. The next question given here is, check whether minus 150 is a term of this AP or not. See, before that they have given that this is the term. Find for which term of the AP this term will come. Now they are asking us, check whether this term is coming in this AP or not. To check that term whether it is in the AP or not, we have to apply the same procedure. And we get the N value correctly, then we will say that will be inside this AP. If you are not getting this N value properly, then we will be saying that this term will not be included in this AP. Now let us apply the same procedure here. If this is the sequence there, means then the first term A is equal to A1 is equal to 11 and D is equal to A2 minus A1, that is equal to 8 minus 11, that is equal to minus 3. The A value, first term value and D value is the. Now the given value minus 150, let us take this is the last term. So AN is equal to minus 150. Now let us apply in the same formula. AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. This is A1. So A1 value is 11. N value we don't know. Into D value is minus 3. This is equal to AN, that is minus 150. Now this 11, take it to next side. So minus 150 minus 11, this is equal to N minus 1 into minus 3. Now this is equal to minus 161. Take this to next side, minus 3, this is equal to N minus 1. Now these two will get cancelled here. Now N is equal to 161 by 3 plus 1. Now see here, N value we will be getting here as 161 by 3 plus 1 is there. Take the LCM. So this is equal to 161 plus 3 by 3 equal to 164 by 3 N. So N value we are getting in the fraction here. So this term N is equal to 150 is not a positive
integer in this one. Therefore, n should be a positive integer. So this given 150 will not be included in this AP set. Therefore, minus 150 is not a term of the given AP. The next question given here is, an AP consists of 50 terms, of which third term is 12 and the last term is 106. Find the 29th term. See, they have said that AP consists of 50 terms. 50 total terms given is 50. Therefore, given n is equal to 50. Third term, that is A1, A2, A3. That is the third term, A3 is equal to 12. That is A plus 2D is equal to 12. Next given, the last term is 106. That is the 50th term is 106. So the last term AN is equal to 106. That is 10. This is equal to AN equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So 106 is equal to A plus N value is 50 minus 1 into D. So this is equal to 106 equal to A plus 49 D. Let us take this as 2. Now these are the two informations given for us. With this we want to find the 29th term. So 29th term we want means we want to find out what is the A value and what is the D value. Both the things we have to find out. Now we have two equations here and two variables there. Now using the method of elimination, let us find both the variable A and D here. Now take these two equations and subtract. So second equation minus first equation, A plus 49D is equal to 106, A plus 2D is equal to 12. Let us do the subtraction. So sign change will be there. Now these are having same alphabet with different signs, so cancel. Now these two is equal to 47D with a plus sign. That is equal to plus 106 minus 12. This is equal to 94. Therefore D is equal to 94 divided by 47. That is equal to 2. So D value we got 2. Now let us substitute the D is equal to 2 in any one of these two equations and let us find the value of A. Now A plus 2 into 2 is equal to 12. Now A is equal to 12. This plus 2 into 2 4 plus 4 when goes next side it will become minus 4. That is equal to 12 minus of 4. That is equal to 8. So A is equal to 8. Now A value we know, D value we know. Now with this we want to find the 29th term. So A 29, this is equal to A plus 29 minus 1 into D. So A value is 8 plus 28 into D value is 2. So this is equal to 8 plus multiply 28 into 2 is equal to 56. This is equal to 64. So A 29 is equal to 64. The next is question number 12. Two APs have the same difference. Given here is two APs are there and that two APs forms the same difference. Now first let us define what are those two APs here. Let the APs are A1, A2, A3 up to AN. Let us be the first AP and B1, B2, B3 keep on moving up to BN. These are the two APs. And they have said that the two APs have the same common difference. That is A2 minus A1. That is also equal to D. This is equal to B2 minus B1. So these two are having the common difference as D. If it is so, and they have said difference between their 100th term is 100. Difference between the 100th term. In this one, we have to find the 100th term. That value is also 100. And in this one, we have to find the 100th term. That term is also 100. That is, A100 is equal to A plus 99D. That is equal to 100. A100 means A plus N minus 1 into D. That N minus 1 is 100 minus 1. That is 99. That is equal to 100. Similarly, B100 is equal to B plus 99D. That is also equal to 100. The difference between their 100th term. Difference between these two terms. Sorry. Here this is not equal to 100. The difference between these two terms is equal to 100. That is A plus 99D minus B plus 99D. This is equal to 100. Sorry, this is not equal to 100. Difference between their term, 100th term is 100 here. Now, if it is so, what is the difference between their 1000th term? If this is so, we want to find what is the difference between the 1000th term. Now, see here, this term minus of this term they have given. Now, from this, let us find what is that. So, A plus, here we have taken A1. So, let us take this also A1. So, A1 plus 99D minus B1 minus 99D, that is equal to 100. So, minus 99 plus 99 both will get cancelled. So, A1 minus B1 is equal to 100. Now, these two is equal to 100 we got. Now, we want to find the difference of the 1000th term. That is A1000 minus of B1000 we have to find out. This is equal to what we have to find out. Now, A1000 can be written as A1 plus 999D minus B1 plus 999D. Why? Because AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. That is A1. So, A1000 is equal to A1 plus 1000 minus 1 into D. That is equal to A1 plus 999D. Similarly, we can write for B also. This is equal to what we have to find out. Now, see here A1 minus of 900 plus 999D minus B1 minus 999D. Now these two will get cancelled. Remaining leftover is A1 minus of B1. Already we have found that A1 minus B1 is equal to 100. So for here also A1 minus B1, this value also it will be equal to 100 only. So the difference between their 1000th term is also 100. Next question is, how many multiples of 4 lies between 10 and 250? Now, we want to find the multiples of 4. See, multiples of 4, here 10 is there. So, 10 next multiple will be 12. So, the multiples of 4, which lies between 10 and 250. See, after 10, the first multiple will be 12, then after that 16, then after that 20, it will be keep on moving. But here they have said that it is 250.
So 250 before that, what is a multiple of 4? We have to find out. So for that, what we can do here is divide this 250 by 4. What remainder we are getting, just subtract that remainder, and so what is a leftover value we are having, that will be the multiple of this 4 last number. So 250 is there, divided by 4. 6 4s are 24 here. So 1 0, 2 4s are 8. So remainder is 2. Now this 2 subtract from this value. So 250 minus 2, that is equal to 248. So 248 will be the multiple of last multiple of 4 in between these two values. So the last here value is 248. Now see here, in this multiples I know the first value a1 is equal to 12, common difference d is equal to 4, because all these are multiples of 4, and the last term an is equal to 248. Now we want to find how many terms are there in between this, that is n value we have to find out. Now n is nothing but an formula, a plus n minus 1 into d. So 248 is equal to 12 plus n minus 1 into 4. So 248 minus 12 equal to n minus 1 into 4. 236 divided by 4 is equal to n minus 1. So n minus 1 is equal to 59, n is equal to 60. Therefore there are 6 multiples of 4 in between this 10, 60 multiples of 4 in between this 10 and 250.